As a longtime financial planner, Dana Anderson knows a good investment.
Well, there's a bunch of opportunity there.
And when he first grew lettuce with this homemade frame in his garage, he started to love a different,
essentially these are our babies,
kind of green.
That really was quite crude, but yeah, just two wrought iron fences leaned together.
5 years later, that idea is now this, Living Greens Farm, housed in an abandoned Faribault warehouse and getting global attention.
And now we're building one of the biggest indoor farms in the world.
And one that may help change it. Using aeroponics, Living Greens Farms is growing lettuce, herbs, and microgreens vertically with just 5% of the water and 1/200th of the land of traditional fields, all without herbicides or pesticides.
Oh, it's amazing.
Fast Company says vertical farms will soon be a $42 billion industry.
But things like this are totally necessary to feed the human population in the future.
Already, it seems futuristic with a high-tech system that eliminates the risk of bad weather.
This is the germination station.
Since light, humidity, nutrients, and temperature are all controlled by computer. That means crops grow year-round in half the time and can be sold the next day, with nearly 24 stores and restaurants already buying their produce. And as its crops thrive, Living Greens is itself growing, expanding to more than 15 times its current size. It may next go worldwide, replicating this in Europe and Asia, in turn creating both food and jobs for those who grow it.
This is an opportunity to grow a product indoors that the community needs, and using the labor force that's available.
As an acre of soil is reduced to this, farms and the idea of what they should look like are growing up. Janelle Klein, Care 11 News.